It is a humid June day, with no wind or moon in sight. Japanese fireflies begin their dance by the stream once the sun has completely disappeared. Their brightness is about 1/500th of a candela. As a single candle is one candela, this is extremely dim. And the surface area of this glow is small, making it difficult to capture on camera. We are finally able to make observations using a weak spotlight once they land on some grass. It is well known that the Japanese firefly glows at 4-second intervals in eastern Japan and 2-second intervals in western Japan. The boundary for this is almost perfectly aligned with Fossa Magna, and there are even reports of 3-second intervals in this vicinity. Why does the same species have different light emission intervals? Actually, there is no accepted theory as to why fireflies glow at all. It is said that they are attracting females, but fireflies start glowing when they are larvae. Males do indeed flash nearby females with short bursts of light, but this differs from the so-called wild dancing performances Japanese fireflies are famous for. The fireflies are probably using light as some form of communication. This conjecture is further exemplified by the synchronized glowing of males that flicker in unison. While varying with weather conditions, the synchronized glowing of males generally occurs within a range of about 5 meters. The nature of the information exchanged is, however, still a complete mystery. But we do know that the area of synchronized glowing is humid and located directly above sites suitable for egg laying. Could it be that fireflies have some kind of sensor for identifying suitable egg-laying locations, which they then broadcast in order to propagate the species as a whole? Adult fireflies lay eggs behind moss and grass during their brief 1-week existence. Newly emerged larvae feed on Malanian snails, climbing up the embankment the following spring to become a pupa. Fireflies must have some kind of sensor by which they have continued this cycle without change. Humans do not have such refined sensors with which to measure the natural world. However, humankind possesses the power of analysis, one that goes beyond our natural limitations. The protection of this diverse and beautiful Earth through the analysis of nature is a mission that has been entrusted to humankind.